Let's quickly review what we've learned about arrays. We learned that arrays are ordered lists of items and that they can have duplicates. For example, here's my array of favorite things, and you can see that raindrops on roses appears twice, and that's totally okay. Because arrays are ordered, we're able to access its items by index. You can see here that we're accessing the first item with the index 0, and we're accessing the fourth item with the index 3. We also went over three different ways to initialize an array. First, using somewhat verbose syntax. Second, by specifying the item type between square brackets. And third, using an array literal. We also saw that in Swift, arrays have types, meaning that they can hold any type you desire, but they can't hold two items that have different types. For example, I can't add a variable of type string to an array of type lightswitch. We also practiced using array operations. Let's see those one more time. Here I have an array of musicians, and I can append an artist to the end of my musicians array using the method append. And I can insert another artist at a particular index using insert at index. And over here, you can see Dej Loaf at index 2. To remove an item from the array, I use remove at index. If I remove the item at index 3, you can see Flowrida is removed. If I want to know how many items are in my array, I use the count method. Right now, I've got 5. And finally, if I want to retrieve an item at a particular index, I can use subscript syntax, like so. And here we can see the third item is Dej Loaf. We also went over copying and concatenating arrays. Array concatenation in Swift is super convenient. We just use the plus operator and we're good to go. To copy an array, we just define our copy to be equal to the value of the original. Arrays are value types, which means that here, array and array copy represent two distinct entities. If I change a value in array copy, you can see that the values in array remain the same. There are exceptions to this, which you'll learn more about in the session on classes. And finally, we talked about how to use fast enumeration to loop through an array. For in loops take the general form for item in collection, and then between curly braces, the statements you want to execute on each item in the collection. For example, to find the sum of all the ints in this array, we just type for value in int array, and this statement adding int to the sum will be executed for each member of the collection. You can see in the playground sidebar that this statement is being executed 5 times. And here, we can see the sum.